Mini Chapter 52, Sun Glare and Skinny Palms in Westmont, South Central. Jaymi scans the contents of the confidential Bangdead document he located, looking first at its handful of embedded screen captures from Google Street View and Bing's Bird's Eye View, then at its embedded artwork from Bangdead's upcoming first-person shooter game, Righteous Gun, and then at its text. That being the order of his attention, the first thing he absorbs is a series of street-level and 45-degree aerial photos depicting a strip of South Vermont Avenue, its two halves divided by a wide dirt median, a desolate stretch of nondescript building façades, beauty supply outlets, motels, liquor stores, and makeshift churches, running north from the Century Freeway for 30 or more blocks through South Central. The sun glare presses down alike on all properties, auto repair places, sudden busy frontages of mini-market stores, and then perhaps a funeral parlour, sober and clean at the front, while its side wall is gang-tagged beside an empty lot. Infrequent on the side streets running west, skinny-trunked palms stand listless in the dusty air of Westmont. Despite its seeming anonymity, this neighbourhood happens to tick a decent number of demographic boxes in Bangdead's current stakeholder matrix of priorities for community outreach, as Jaymi learns from the captions under the images. Through just such matrices are tomorrow's gamers discovered, many of whom will be nurtured into loyal customers, and among these, the super gamers, Bangdead champions and company ambassadors of the future. Dud's team has therefore reached out to one of the more sizable local congregations here, housed on the avenue in faded and incomparably weary-looking premises, and has engaged this church in a joint venture. In consideration for an appropriate donation of funds, the church has undertaken to integrate a permanent Bangdead-branded facility into the community. There, on Vermont, on the southwest corner of 104th Street, is a small vacant lot enclosed by the motel beyond it. On this vacant lot, a new and well-wired gaming hut named the Righteous Gun Cockpit will soon arise. The Cockpit's principal stated mission is to promote a Bangdead game called Righteous Gun, which is to be closely tied in with Ain’tTheyFreaky's Guy Score newsfeed. Its secondary stated mission is something that Jaymi can see is really just a piece of branding designed to appeal to this particular community's leaders. This mission is to promote the spiritual dimension in first-person shooter games by promising a life meaning to the lost, by bringing righteousness back into shooting, and by bringing the good fight back into righteousness. Bangdead has even been brazen enough to mention the Ten Commandments as a solid basis for the duty of every righteous shooter, whether first person or second or third, to uphold the fabric of society against those who would threaten the traditional roles of its menfolk and its womenfolk. The copy is well targeted. Jaymi wrinkles his nose. Then he gets up, trots downstairs and through the house to the door of the guest wing, knocks and waits for its resident to appear. The door opens. "Hey!" Evelyn twinkles at him, chowing down hungrily on a banana as she stands there in a yellow bikini. "Evelyn, hi. So mission time approaches. I just wanted to give you a heads up that I'll be coming back late this afternoon when I'll need you to be ready to go meet Amber and shoot down to South Central with him." She looks crestfallen. "Jaymi, I was planning to do busy work this afternoon. Does the trip have to happen today?" "Yes, it does. Look, I can promise your mission with Amber will be way more fun than just fudging around miserably at home all day. I mean, what on earth do you have to do here?" She looks around the room behind her. "Oh, I don't know, but so many things. You know, hoover the floor, pay the milkman. I can't remember what else, but you name it and it has to be done." "Sod all that. You're an incarnated beast of Electra Drive who's meant to be jetting glamorously around LA." "I don't know whether I'm such a fan of this meat space you've brought me into," she says. "It's felt a bit like making my first parachute jump for charity, only to fall straight into the whirling blades of a helicopter." "Now you're being a drama queen. Surely real life isn't quite that bad." "Well, maybe not," she concedes. "Still, it's a bit of a schlep, isn't it?" "It is that, I do admit," says Jaymi. "But this mission is important, Evelyn. It'll make the world a little better. Would that be okay with you?" She heaves a sigh, nods tragically, and gives a brave smile. "Okay, Jaymi. I'll be ready. See you later." He stands there, watching her door swing shut. Then he strides up the hallway, fuming with exasperation, tense with uncertainty, and filled up with love.